Welcome back to World of Warcraft. We're playing an Undead Warrior, and we're back in the Undercity. We're starting here in this episode because we have a couple of quests to finish before we can go back to the Sepulchre. I want to say that we're almost done with Tirisfal Glades.
Be quick about your business.
Now, the Weapon Merchant is for the supplying the Sepulchre quest. We need to bring back some weapons. So we get the crate, we need to go back to Michael Garrett.
Victory for Sylvanas.
We'll accept that.
What is it?
Let me deposit some of the ore that we found, some of the gems. Can't really use them at this point. We can head over to the bat handler here.
What would you ask of death? What now?
Accept this one, and now we have to get back to the Sepulchre.
Trust no one.
Before we do that, however, there's another little quest for the Lich's spellbook. That is at the magic quarter. Yeah. There's the auctioneer. We can sell some of the stingy wolf meat. Shift click. And they sell for about a gold piece. Let's place that. Yeah, that should be good. Some bear meat. Maybe people want that as well. Some of these weapons as well. That and the disciples' pants of the eagle. There was an orc warlock. Just use a hearthstone. And we'll speak to Bethor.
Trust no one.
And hand the book in.
Victory for Sylvanas.
There's a follow-up to return the... Oh, we have to go back to the Brightwater Lake. Yeah, I don't think there's any point in going back there. This is a much lower level quest. So my plan for this episode is that before we head out, we need to speak to the innkeeper. Undercity seems like a fine place to have the Hearthstone set at.
I am forsaken.
So let's do just that.
Our time will come.
And we take the elevator up. If you remember, when we asked the weapon master about weapon training, he did mention that there's quite a bit in Silvermoon City. So I was thinking, let's use the orb that is outside the capital here to teleport there directly. We have enough money to get some of these weapon skills, probably thrown weapons. This is gonna give us a ranged option, which is exactly what we need right now. It will help with pools, it will help with dealing enemies some damage while they're approaching or running away. So it should be just to the left. And we're here. Silvermoon City, home of the Blood Elves. To do now is speak to one of the guardians.
We will persevere.
What we need is the weapon master. The Blood Knights in Farstrider Square graciously allow space within their halls for Illida. Is that how it's pronounced? The weapon master of Silvermoon. While her training is not cheap, you'll appreciate her expertise.
Death to all who oppose us.
We have some money to spare. Shouldn't be that bad. So we're heading to the Farstrider Square. Just need to make a left here. There's the engineering department. And I'll have to admit, the atmosphere here is a lot nicer and more peaceful than the Undercity. Gunsmith, bowers. And this is the class hall for paladins.
Glory to the Sindori. Our
enemies will fall. They have trainers, some quest NPCs.
What business have you?
So let's get to weapon training. Pole arms is not available, not that we have any at this point. We get bows and thrown weapons. Now the question is, where can I buy some throwing weapons? These are bows.
Death to all who oppose us.
We'll be able to make some guns with engineering, eventually. But we need to get to Thunderbluff before we can use them. We're almost outside. Alesta's the first aid trainer. Not bad at all. Level 10 little paladin here. Someone just purchased all the cooking materials I listed. Sky Mistress Gloaming.
Victory lies ahead. Keep your wits about you.
Oh, that's right. We can't really fly anywhere. A couple of quests in this area. They're level 10. Ghostlands are a bit higher level. I wonder if it's worth going there. Then again, it's probably enough for us to do in Silverpine Forest. We can come back here later, though. What else could we do in Silvermoon before we head back? Can't think of much else. So let's use the Hearthstone here. Which is gonna save us some time, and we can fly directly to the Sepulchre. Do you have thrown weapons, perhaps? No, you do not. Let's try some of the underventors here. Trade supplies. It would make sense if they sold weapons. General goods.
I haven't got all day.
Oh, here we are. Throwing knives, axes. What is the best option available? That's for level 50. 22. We can buy these.
Goodbye.
And done. Throw ability.
This had better be good. Watch your back.
And we can leave the Undercity now. It doesn't display how many thrown weapons we have. Maybe I remember that wrong, but these used to run out. You would buy 100 or 200 of them, you would use them and needed to purchase them again. Here we are at the sepulcher. Let's grab the next batch of quests and head out. We have the
Hello.
Remedy of Arugal.
Beware the living.
After examining Arugal's work, my worst suspicions were confirmed. The old hack was not qualified to clean chamber pots in Dalaran, let alone represent the Kirin Tor in its most dire hour. He used enchanted items to reinforce his weak magic. Need to examine these. And we need to slay Moonrage Gluttons and Dark Souls and bring back these shackles.
Remember. Speak quickly.
Complete the delivery here.
Our time will come.
Good experience, too. The money I'm not worried about anymore. The amount that we get from the quests really is pitiful compared to selling some low-level simple items.
Watch your back. I am forsaken.
One more for the Executor.
Patience. Discipline.
And now we need to speak with Renfero, the apothecary.
Trust no one.
Renfero.
Speak quickly.
There is a matter regarding the wolf hearts you brought to me earlier that demands our attention. Oh, really?
Dark
what could
lady.
That be? The hearts you acquired possess a quality unseen in similar specimens. There is a toxicity to them that should be deadly to the very wolves in which the hearts beat. It's quite incredible and we must study it further. So we need to deliver it to the Undercity.
Trust no one.
It would have been really helpful if you had that quest available for us before we head back there. One more reason for the Undercity. Let's take the shortcut here. Jump down the cliff. We can sharpen the weapon again. And get some attack power. There's an entire group here. There's one of them. Let's try throwing a couple of weapons. Good opportunity to increase the thrown weapon skill as well. The dead field. Is this where we need to be? The dead field. Oh, this is for the Nightlash. Thank you. And we probably have to just keep killing them. Shield Bass is just an exceptionally good ability. We can interrupt these heals. No sign of Nightlash yet. Maybe she's in here? Doesn't look like it. Thank you. Oh, here we are. Level 14 undead, Nightlash. That quest is complete, finally. Pioneer Trousers of the Eagle. Can't really use that. Don't have much need for intellect. Hopefully we can sell them though. Glad to see that some of the cooking material also sold bear meat. Don't remember how much I listed that for. Final bear heart. We can stop hunting these now. Skittering blood. So I'm guessing the spiders are infesting this mine as well. There's a bear running around. Not sure why. Oh, some tin. And a shadow gem. Already. I should probably head inside. Maybe we can get some more. Just one more. Now, what else is available? We still need some of these shackles from the Moonraid's gluttons. And we need to grab the contents of the Dalaran crates. So we can loop around until we reach the sepulcher again. There's another fisherman. I don't think I have the patience for fishing. Spiked glob. We'll pick that up. Hopefully someone will buy it. I'm pretty sure we listed one on the auction house. Some hostile fish down there. Somehow I expected these to be a bit stronger. There's some strangle kelp for the herbalists out there. And I have to get to the shore. Not much for us underwater. That's a level 20 LV. Hopefully they won't return here. Thank you. Seeing that level 20 elite is making you somewhat nervous. I feel I'm about to be jumped at any moment. Okay, one more talent point. We can get block, we can get insight. 5% crit chance. Chance to dodge. That's also very good. Okay, let's try anticipation. Our skill in thrown weapons is already 72. Should we head back to the sepulcher? One more quest to do. Although that's further south. I'm going to check the copper ore here and head back. One-handed mace here. And of course, the inventory is full. We can use the fallen log to cross. That deer doesn't look too well. Okay. Let's follow the road instead. This must be another level 20 elite. There's no way the one we saw near the beach actually passed around and came here, right? That wouldn't make sense. Power to destroy. This should be around our level now. Maybe we should queue up for this dungeon, see if other people are available for it. We have a... We got a shield, we have some talent points. In the protection tree, we should be good.
your back.
That better be good.
I will need 6 shackles and 3 Dark Soul shackles before I can assess the situation and devise a final solution for Argo.
Beware the living.
We have everything. It will indeed take me longer than I had thought to uncover the dark secrets behind the enchantments. But in the meantime, I need you to take of a slight problem or death... No. Darkstalkers. That's a new term, right? It seems that Arugal let his magic spread to the Deep Elm Mine in the hills to the southeast. The mine would prove to be quite a resource for Varimartha's advance. I want you to behead the tainted foreman of the mine, Grimson the Pale.
Our time will come.
So that's the next part. We found that mine earlier, but decided not to head inside. The enemies were much higher, I want to say. The dead fields. Complete that.
Our enemy is abound.
We have a quest called the Decrepit Fairy. We've discovered a new hive for the Scourge, the Decrepit Fairy. It lies to the east of the Sepulchre and is heavily patrolled by Rawhides and other undead. There must be a reason for the Scourge's occupation of the area. Find out why the Scourge are there.
Beware the living.
What is it?
Hello.
Reconnaissance boots. These are cloth. Can't really use them. And now, we could use the group finder here. We can't really heal anyone. Don't have the... I'm not sure why this is even available. Damage, tank, that should be good. We welcome new players. Sure, no problem. Ragefire is 13 to 20, so at 15 we should be good. And now we have to wait. These are high level mages. I'm not sure why they're listed. Who else is there? There's a rogue, Canewood. Let's wait for a couple more people. That's a new farmstead. Completely overrun by the Scourge. Ravenclaw slaves.
Yeah.
So these are apprentice mages, I take? So the crate is in the middle of the camp. Canewood invites us. I think it's the rogue that was listed for the dungeon. Let's say hello. I think it's best if we don't charge in there. And instead, we pull them back. There's a mana potion. Since we're doing a dungeon, maybe we can save it, give it to one of the casters in the group. So this is the crate we need. Prying open the lid of the crate, you find an assortment of carefully packed objects. On the top of the crate lies a bundle of maps, yellow... Oh no. Oh, this is not good. This is not good at all. We have to run away. Was not expecting them to respawn so quickly. We need to be more careful. Spellbinder gloves. Don't really care about the clock. All right, now we can finish that quest. Underneath the maps is a mysterious looking magical pendant. And we need to take it back to the Shadow Priest. There's a warlock running around. And I can see the mine further ahead. I'm guessing the foreman is actually deep inside the mine. Thank you. Okay, we're a bit low here. Nothing can spawn behind us. That's a... Whoa. There we go. Let's not risk it. Let me just sell a couple of these items. To make some space. Okay, this should not take long. I don't want to keep the other people waiting. Not a lot to sell. Well, that's fine.
And you, what do you require?
There's a recipe for death.
Trust no one.
And the next one is in Pyrewood Village. Bearer Journal.
Victory for Sylvanas.
I am forsaken.
The Wolfheart samples. That's pretty good. And the final part is for the Barons.
Our time.
Hey, these are better. And we can give the mana potion to the shaman. Is that the quest for the instance? It probably is.
Strength and honor.
Slaying the beast. Taragamon the Hunger.
For the horde.
We also have a quest to share. Someone is sharing more with us. Searching for the lost satchel. Okay. Okay, this marker is getting annoying. Taking too much of the screen. Did that get applied again? Hold on. Let me remove it. That's a decent item. Let's take a moment to equip that. And we equip it. This is leather.
Hmm.
We can sharpen the weapon as well. We're doing great so far. This is probably the first boss. Ogleflint. Flint. Ragefire Chasm. Yeah, that Tauren did not make it. This is the satchel that we wanted. Take the satchel back to Rahauro in Thunderblood. I remember this part of the dungeon, and it can get a bit messy here. Here's the next boss. And we have to be very careful. From the Nether. That's the Undercity quest. Okay, now what? That's an upgrade for us. Let's equip that before the boss. To interrupt that. We have a buckler, don't really need that. 3 points of intellect. Subterranean cape. Now this is a good one. Can we pull those back? Hopefully before the patrol. Okay, that should work. Had to use a potion there, just in case. Court of the Monkey. Shaman traded that shield, but it really isn't that good. Then again, 1 point of stamina. Fine. It's an upgrade. We'll thank him and hopefully. This is another difficult part. Yeah. cloth boots. Spells of Shadow. That's the final one. Rogue managed to interrupt that before we did. Shotgun and a shadowy wand. Jeragos, this is probably the final boss. And here we are. Robe of Evocation. That's a very good item. I wonder who is going to win this. Mage, the Warlock will also want this. Oh, apparently not. Oh, right, there's a shortcut here. Question is there another boss up here? Bajalan? That's another demon? No, it's a humanoid. Cloth piece. Don't really care. And that was it. Bajalan and the Invoker down there are probably needed for some quests that we do not have. The others are done, though. All we need to do is just head out. And that should conclude the video. Accomplished quite a lot. Even finished our first dungeon here, in Ragefire Chasm. And it also saved us the trip on the Zeppelin to reach Orgrimmar. Hope you enjoyed it so far, and hope to see you on the next one. Take care.